Well, it is the Cavs' 50th season, so that does bring a lot of the legends back to town, starting with Coach Lenny Wilkens. Being here, seeing everyone, I know it's a new name, a new hallway and decorations, but any memories that come back to you for your time?
Well, I have a lot of fond memories, you know, because I was here twice. I came here as a player. I played a couple of years and then left and then came back, and I was a coach. And certainly coaching a lot of these young men, it was a lot of fun for me because, you know, we didn't win a championship, but we established a culture where guys came to play every night, and we had tremendous support from the fans. We used to play at the Richfield Coliseum, what was called a snow belt at that time. And we averaged over 20,000 fans a game. So they loved what we were doing. And so to see all of them, I haven't seen a lot of them in quite a while. So it was just great to be back.
You mentioned some of those players. If any memories from those games stand out to you, just some of your favorite times with those guys?
Well, I had a lot of favorite times. You know, Larry Nance was, we traded for him, you know, and he didn't want to come at first, but once he got here, he loved it. And he kept our locker room loose. You know, he kept the players ready because he had nicknames for all of them. And that was a wonderful time. I used to tell people all the time, because I coached against Karl Malone and John Stockton. People at that time said that they were the best combination of running a screen and roll. Well, I'd put Mark Price and Brad Daugherty against them at any time. So we had some wonderful times here. The only time that I got upset was when they traded Ron Harper. And I was against that still, but I'm over it. But now, finally, it took a lot of years.
Well, the Cavs have some youth with them as well, just as far as the development that you had and then the comparison to now. What are some keys in order to doing that?
Well, I think the key is always is that young people have to hear you, okay? They got to be willing to listen and pay attention and know history. History is a great teacher, okay? And if you see what happened before you, and maybe it helps you to avoid certain mistakes and things like that. But most of all, you have to be willing to listen. You have to be willing to work at it, you know, so that you can improve.
Well, Coach, thank you so much for your time. Welcome back to Cleveland, and I'm excited to celebrate you guys and the legends for the rest of the time while you're here.
Well, thank you. Thank you for having us.
Back to you, Jeff.